Nahi jnanena sadrisam pavitram ihavidyate tat sang yoga sang siddhya kalena atmani vindati. Therefore, knowledge, we must seek knowledge. And the perfection of knowledge, as we have several times explained in this meeting, the perfection of knowledge is to understand Krishna. That's all. As in the seventh chapter, we'll find that bahunam janmanavante jnanavan maam prapadyate. After culturing many, many births, knowledge, one comes to Krishna and he understands Vasudeva sarvamiti sa mahatma sudullava. Vasudeva, Krishna is everything, all causes of, is the cause of all causes. Always remember, when I speak of Krishna, it's God. God is the cause of all causes. Now, in these days of communism, the idea of communism, now, in the Krishna science, there is very nice conception of spiritual communism in the Krishna science. In the Srimad Bhagavad, you will find that there was a discussion between Narada and Yudhishthira, and Narada was explaining that in this manifested material world, either in the higher planets or in this planet or in the outer space, whatever wonderful things and resources, material resources are there, they are all manufactured by the Supreme Lord. Just try to understand. Everything in this world, whatever there is, that is not done by any human being. That is done by God. Nobody can deny it. Isavasamidam sarvam. Therefore, all living entities, beginning from the ant to Brahma, the highest human being or the highest demigod, all of them, they have got the right to use them. They have got the right to use them. Now, Narada says that you can use all these material resources as much as you require. But if you want more, if you get more, then you become the thief and you are punished. Just see the idea of communism. Everything in the world, in this planet or in other planet, just like people are trying to go to the moon planet. The Russians are trying to put their flag first so that if they go to moon planet, they'll conquer. Just like you came from Europe, you have conquered this tract of land, America, and you have put up your flag. So now they are trying to go to the moon planet. But this putting this, digging the flag, it is called ignorance. This is called ignorance. Where you are putting your flag, it is not your property. It is God's property. This is knowledge. This is knowledge. And if I think it is my property, I must dig my flag here. That is ignorance. So, in the Srimad Bhagavat you will find that whatever properties, in this morning also I was speaking, just if you throw in the street some bags of grains, the pigeons will come. But they will pick up only 4, 5, 6, 8, 10 grains and they will go out. They will not take even one grain more than it needs. As soon as he is satisfied to his heart's content, I am filled up, he will go out. It will go out. He will not stop. Similarly, this is natural. This is natural. But if we put here 100 bags of flour, and if we ask people to come and take, then somebody will take 10 bags, somebody will take 15 bags, somebody will take, will not take any bag because if he is weak, he cannot take. So all the distribution will not be equal. That is our advancement of civilization. The knowledge which the pigeons, the cats and dogs have got, we are lacking in that knowledge. That the whole thing belongs to the Supreme Law, and we can accept them, whatever we need, not more than that. That is knowledge. That is knowledge. There will be no difficulty. The whole world is made by the Lord's arrangement that you have no scarcity. Everything is sufficient. Everything is sufficient. There will be no scarcity, provided you know the distribution. But the distribution is, there is fallacy, distribution. One is taking more and the other is starving. Therefore, the starving population, they are making protests. Why we shall starve? But that is also defective. The here is the perfect knowledge that Ishavasmidam Sarvam. We have to take everything as God's property, nobody's property. And we can use things which are available by the nature's product. Suppose there is iron ore mine. So everyone has got the whatever iron he requires, he can take. But if somebody makes the iron mine as his own property, then according to Srimad Bhagavad, he becomes a thief. He becomes a thief and he is punishable. Because that is God's property. Nobody can create the iron mine. We cannot create anything, even in the economic laws. We cannot create anything. We can simply transform, just like worker and labor. That's all. Suppose we manufacture a very nice table, but the ingredient, the wood, and the instrument, iron, this is supplied by God. You cannot manufacture iron, you cannot manufacture the wood. So why do you claim that it is yours? This is ignorant. This is ignorant. So, by culture of Krishna science, when you understand the Krishna science, then we become free from this ignorance. And Lord Krishna recommends that by this knowledge, you can very easily cross over the ocean of mis-science, ocean of ignorance. The whole thing you are suffering due to, just like ignorance is no excuse in the law court. Suppose you have done something wrong, and if you say to the judge, so I did not know, sir, this law, that is no excuse. You will be punished. You will be punished. Now in the Shastra, in the Vedic literature, it is said that everything belongs to God. Everything is manufactured by God. So everyone has rights, not only human beings, even the animals. Everyone has got the right to live and use things as much as he requires. But if he stocks more, if he acquires more, he becomes the thief and he is punished. Now suppose if I say, I do not know this law, therefore I have accumulated so much things in my control. That does not mean that you will not be punished. You will be punished. You will be punishable. This knowledge you require to know. And people at the modern age, they are lacking this knowledge. So we require hundreds and thousands of spiritual masters who has understood this Krishna science and preach all over the world. That is the problem. Therefore we have formed this society. And we invite all sincere souls to take part in this society and become a spiritual master and preach this science all over the world. Oh. There is a great necessity of this knowledge. Don't think that Krishna was born in India and because he spoke on the Vedic principle there is a sectarian thing. No. Krishna says that sarvajonishu kauntya sambhavanti murtayaja tasang mahajani brahma ahanga bijapadapita. Just like children, they are born after the conjugation of the father and the mother. Similarly, the father is God. The material world is the mother. We have got this body, just like the child gets his body from the mother's womb. The father is the seed giver. Similarly, as spiritual soul, we are part and parcel of the Supreme Lord. But we are put into this material world because we wanted to enjoy this material world. Therefore, we are put into this material world. And we have got this body, this material world. So, in whatever form we may be, either as human being or as a cat and dog or a more than human being, demigod, so whatever form there are, many thousands, 84 lakhs species. Oh, 800 million of species of life there are, but all of them is claimed by Krishna that I am their father. I am their father. Ahanga bijapadapita. Ahanga means I. Bijapadapita, I am the seed-giving father. So, Bhagavad Gita, the science of Krishna, is not meant for any particular party, a particular nation, or a particular country. It is all meant for everyone, even for the animals. So we have to learn this science and preach this science all over the world so that they can be out of the ignorance. They are committing theft. They are committing theft. So we have to save them from the ignorance, state of ignorance. This is required. So we have formed this association, internal association for Krishna, internal society for Krishna consciousness. And I invite every one of you, not only in America, from all parts of the world, come and join and learn this Krishna science and preach all over the world, that people will be happy. It is the business of the human being not to exploit each other. The human being is meant for doing good to others. Lord Chaitanya preached this philosophy, especially he advised to the Indians, Bharat bhumite manushya janma haila ja, janma sarthak kari karo paropaka. He said that anyone who has taken birth in the land of India, because India is the land of religion, India is the land of philosophy. India has got very good many aspects of the science of Krishna and science of spiritual knowledge. So anyone who has taken his birth in India, they can fulfill the mission of human life. They have got very good assets. But unfortunately, they have rejected all these assets. They are now enamored by the glamour of material civilization. They are looking to Europe and America and they want this skyscraper building and industry. And in that way they want to be happy now. So, but actually, that is not the way. That is rather misleading. The more we shall advance this material way of life, the more we shall be away from spiritual life. The human life is meant for the spiritual realization, nothing more. We shall be satisfied. Whatever is supplied by nature, by the order of God. Nature supplies us many things for our maintenance. There are number of grains, there are number of fruits, there is ample supply of meal. So you can satisfy yourself, you can keep your body very healthy and culture the spiritual knowledge. That is the plan. That is the plan of Krishna. But if we want to possess more, then so this is another example of punishment. You see, we are also punished, and the for whom they are going, they are also punished. So we are all being punished. As we are making progress, as we are violating the law of nature, the law of God, we are being punished in every state. But due to ignorance, we do not know how we are being. We have been accustomed. We have been callous. Let us be punished. Go on. Oh, this is not human life. We must make a solution of this punishment. That is human life. Because I am put into jail all night, it is very good. Without working, I am getting 2 times food. Let me remain in the jail. Oh, that is not very intelligent. Because we must get out of the jail. So, this material world is just like a prison house. We must get out of it. We must get our freedom, the absolute freedom, Satchidananda Vigraha, full of knowledge, full of bliss and eternity. That is our mission. So this knowledge we must get. Knowledge is the solution. This is the subject matter of our speech today. Knowledge is the solution. This is knowledge, that everything belongs to Krishna or God. We can use them as much as we like. Just like the elephant is eating 100 pounds. Oh, God is sublime. Yeah, come on, take 100 pounds. But he is not stalking. He is eating both times, 100 pounds in the morning, 100 pounds in the evening. He supplied. Well, nature supplied. Come on. You know, gorilla. They are very big animals. And where gorillas are prominent in the African jungles, there is a tree which produces a nut which is stronger than the iron bullets. And the gorilla uses those as peas and chew it nicely. So there is food supply there for the gorilla, for the elephant, and for the ant also. The ant requires 1 grain of sugar, and he is also strength. So here is a struggle, but the supply is there. Supply is there. Supply is already fixed up. So your struggle should be human form of life. The struggle should be how to realize yourself, how to go to, go back to God and go back to Krishna. That should be your struggle, not for economic development. The economic solution is there. If it is there for the elephant, for the ant, why not for you? Because we are in ignorance, we are thinking that we have to devote more time for economic development than to spiritual realization. No. And the whole thing is planned like that, that for economic development you need not attempt. You simply try for spiritual realization, for getting out of this entangled of material life. That is knowledge. And that will make your solution. Thank you very much. If there is no question, you can ask.